This is the TM Cup series. I'm your host, Cynon44, and this is the season finale at the DEUCATOR Raceway in Illinois. The points battle today is between Alexis Rainsford in the 98 and James Lombardi in the 50. Lombardi is 91 points behind Rainsford. The pole sitter was Kevin Colley in the 36 because the lineup was set by points, and Colley's team had none coming into this race, and therefore he sat in the pole. The 98 of Alexis Rainsford and James Lombardi's 50 car, therefore, made up the rear of the field. Marcos Leonard made his debut in the 28 car. He raced in Japan, but he didn't do very well. Leonard's 28 car was very fast in all the practice sessions, and he quickly passed Troy Constantine in the 07 to take second place early. 28 car would be a force to reckon with all day long. Alexis Rainsford in the 98 and James Lombardi in the 50 were both running in the low 30s. However, the only thing the 98 needed to do was to stay on Lombardi's bumper. Caution 1 was on lap 2, surprisingly at the front of the field. Troy Constantine passed Marcus Leonard for second, and then he slid through the grass and into the Coca-Cola signs in the first turn. Constantine went on to finish the race, but however, the 07 would need to be towed to the pits. The 57 of Doug Baker led in the restart because everyone made green flag pit stops, except for Baker and his teammate Kirk Pliskin in the 16. Pliskin proved to have the better car than Baker and easily passed him for the lead. Dale Roswell in the 34 car, you're going to see, is running in third. Jordan Roller, you're going to see, takes a little slide to the grass. Tony Durbin does so also. The 50 of James Lombardi quickly was running in the 20s. Alexis Rainsford, on the other hand, was still running in about 34th place. At this time, Lombardi would not win the championship, but he would be close. Unfortunately for the fans, the points battle would end fairly early in the race. Scott Bates in the number 3 car is going to get turned into the grass by Matt Shinosky. He's going to slide back onto the racetrack. There's James Lombardi in the 50 car, nailing Scott Bates in the side as he rolls in the grass. Bates would be okay. He would walk away from this one. There's the 3 into the outside wall. There's the 50 right there. That's going to crush the engine on the 50 car and take him out of the race early on. The 98 of Alexis Rainsford was not involved. You're going to see this. We're going to have a chase cam on the 50. You're going to see the trouble start near the top of the screen. You're going to see the 3 car and the 01 slide into the grass and then come back up the racetrack. Nowhere to go for Lombardi. Just an innocent victim. And that, my friends, is the sound of a championship going down the drain. All that work that the 50 car had, all for nothing. Chris Johans led in the restart, but then he brought the field to green flag pit stops, making Timmy Mack in the 81 car the leader until caution 3 on lap 24. Mike Hammond Jr. in the 70 car spins on the same spot that Troy Constantine did. However, Alexis Rainsford in the 98 car is going to come play in the grass with him. You're going to see the 98 slide and hit the Coke signs. Rainsford had already locked up the title by now, and she didn't even need to be running the race right now, but she was still doing it. Both cars needed to be towed. On pit road, there was trouble as Lauren Beatty's car gets hit by the 52 and then runs into the back of the 7, taking her out. Jordan Roller was the leader until caution 4 flew on lap 27. Two of the best cars in the racetrack would both be taken out of the race. Lewis Kingston in the 84 is going to hit the rumble strips, and Stephanie McGlynn's going to get into him, taking both cars into the wall. Kingston would end up parking that car, and McGlynn would be called for a trip to the hauler. Bruno Battaglia simultaneously was turned around by Nick Phillip in the 83 car. Battaglia goes into the fence. Julian Nosev on the 1 runs into Phillip when he slides back on the racetrack, and the 1 car would also go to the garage. After hauling it back to the pits, that is. Timmy Mack in the 81 led in the restart, the South Park Chevrolet leading quite a few laps and had the best performance of the season. Caution 5 on lap 45 was not what most people wanted to see. John Broughton, Ryan Moody go into the sand and then into the outside wall. Both cars would continue on, but they weren't too happy with each other for a while. A big concern for the leaders, Drew Eisenman and Mario Marquez, however, was fuel mileage. Everybody would have to pit with just 2 laps to go, except for a few cars that would have to pit with 1 to go, unless a caution flew, and a caution ended up flying on lap 52 with just 2 laps to go. Bruno Battaglia in the 51 is going to go on the Rumble Strips, and Johnny Ada in the 04 is going to turn him around. This isn't going to cause the caution, but what's going to happen is Battaglia pulls back on the racetrack, and then Paul Calhoun turns him around, and this is what brings the yellow out, because he slides across the racetrack and he's not going forwards. This would give, literally, the race win to Dale Roswell because he was in fourth and did not have to pit with this two to go. Marquez and Eisenman effectively gave up the lead to the 34 of Dale Roswell, with Tony Durbin in the number two car finishing in second. In third was Zelda Ashby, then Jordan Roller, Doug Baker, Jeff Ruddle, Kurt Pliskin. Marcus Leonard fell back through the field after he made a bad pit stop. Stephanie McGlynn and then Jennifer Evans round out the top 10. However, this did not reflect who was leading towards the end of the race, as Roswell was in fourth. Alexis Rainsford, who was declared the champion after about 11 laps into the field, celebrated with victory burnouts. Season 2 registrations for the TM Cup Series are now open. You can either go to EarnhardtFanRacing.com or contact me personally for those of you who do not have accounts there. The final point standings are at this URL listed here. I do not have time to list them all right now. That's all for this season and the TM Cup Series. I'll see you next time.